I mean, like, I've been approached. I'm serious.
Anybody out there.
That's what people want. People, these days, like, on a YouTube channel, that's the shit they want to hear. They want to hear that, like, you got fucked over by Hollywood already. You know what I mean? Seriously, I'm not joking. It's all, the more transparency you can have, that's what people want.
Well, I'll let you reach the subject.
I will.
No talk problem. About that.
It's broached the subject, but I'm glad that you're going to get words wrong. That's going to help us.
I'm here with my friend and comic, Julian McCullough. That's him. You may know him and have seen him before on Love Your Meaning, Whitney Cummings.
No! Okay. Jesus Christ, that's so embarrassing. I have an hour special coming out.
He has an hour special
coming out, and I just did the Late Late Show with James Corden. And then you can Google me because it's the internet and it's 2017, so don't worry about it. But he brought up something I got canceled 5 years ago, so. Talk about a hype man. That's great. Jimmy, you might know Jimmy.
If you Google me, I do birthdays of a mitzvah in Dallas, Texas. The name Jimmy Crumb.
Oh, really?
That's what I do.
Oh, there's another Jimmy Crumb?
There is. Yeah,
oh, wow. He's killing it.
He's crushing it.
Cool.
That guy's got way more work than I do. We're here in our kitchen at Destination Dogs. We are going to make some special dogs today for Julian, what he requested.
I know nothing about food, like zero. So I was just like, can you make a cheeseburger hot dog? And you were like, it's a sausage, and yes. So I'm really excited.
Yeah, so I mean, here at Destination Dogs, that's what we try to do. We use the world's like great cuisines as the inspiration in our sandwiches, and we just come up with something that really reflects the places that people are from. Apparently, Julian is from where people like cheeseburgers as hot dogs. So that's where we're
going. Yeah, Philadelphia. It's the most garbage cuisine city in the world, and I'm proud to be from there.
This is also where our second location is, Philadelphia.
Perfect.
Actually do a cheesesteak on a sausage there. To
of
make
course you do.
Like,
so we're going to make a cheeseburger dog, and then
we're going to make a...
I also asked for andouille. I love andouille sausage.
Yes.
You already have an andouille sausage on the menu.
I do. It's called the andouille Armstrong. So
okay.
That's a shrimp and alligator sausage.
Gross.
And it's,
I'm just kidding. It sounds amazing.
It's top.
I had it. It's great.
Thank you.
Yeah.
So I did one for you. It is a andouille sausage with pork and alligator.
Okay.
And it's topped with cabbage, topped with your remoulade, tomatoes,
okay.
And fried shrimp and some scallions. So it's
wow.
Like a traditional New Orleans sandwich.
Yeah.
It's pretty awesome. It's like a po' boy sandwich. It's got a pickle on there too.
Sounds amazing. It sounds worth going to New Orleans for.
So that's the one dog. And with the cheeseburger dog, I named this one the Jules Mac. It's kind of our tribute to a Big Mac and Julian.
All right.
It's
also my Twitter handle, Jules Mac. So anybody doesn't
care.
You're the only adult, by the way. Me and Jimmy go way back. I started out in comedy here 12 years ago or something like that. Jimmy was my bartender, and he's the only one ever let call me Jules as an adult. That's how charismatic this guy is. It's not showing up on camera, but he's a really likable guy. Okay, so Jules Mac is...
Jules Mac is a...
like a Big Mac, but Jules Mac.
Yeah, so it's a burger sausage. It's ground chuck and onions in the sausage, and then on top it's secret sauce. It's cheese, it's cabbage, it's lettuce, it's onions, it's sesame seeds.
That's awesome.
Yeah, man, I'm excited.
I can't wait to to try and get that down.
Yes.
That's an Elliott Smith tattoo. That's awesome.
Thank you very much.
Right. So you're a really sad guy? You're like a sad
guy? Yeah,
book.
I'm pretty mopey. These sausages are so uplifting. He cries into each one of them.
I mean, I'm an emotional eater, so I want a guy who's an Elliott Smith fan making my... Are you recording this? What's New Brunswick? I feel like it's all fancy now. When I went to college, it's the home of Rutgers, obviously.
Yeah.
And when I went here, it was like, no frills, let's say.
There was Fat Cat.
You worked at the fanciest bar in New Brunswick.
I did. We used to make martinis that consisted of every flavor of vodka and cranberry. It was quite
even
awesome.
Even the martini bar was like a little bit for kids.
Yeah.
You know?
Dude, do you eat hot dogs?
Hot dogs. And I know that they're supposed to be bad for you, but as long as you don't get the nitrates thing, right?
Yeah.
It's okay, right?
They're fine.
How's it different?
Moderation is the key.
Well, that's not my thing. Moderation. It's gourmet. Right?
You could say it's gourmet, but
I'm good.
You always want to do comedy?
I always thought it was funny, and then the first time I tried comedy, I was like, maybe this isn't for me. I bombed so hard at the Stress Factory, it was unreal. That night, the feeling in the room, there was 400 people, the owner just put me up.
Yeah.
Benny Brad just put me up in front of a sold out crowd. But the feeling in the room was like, why are they making this poor guy do comedy? Like, nobody understood it. I went home that night and drank a vodka handle in my roommate's bed. I couldn't even sleep in my own bed. I was so depressed. And but I stuck with it.
Yeah.
And, you know, tonight I played for 40 people, so everything's going great.
That's so awesome.
Yeah. Did you always know that you wanted to make sausages?
No, I used to do comedy, but it was it didn't really work
out. I remember that. I used to host the open mic.
Yeah, it was there was a lot of bombing and some success, but it was like one joke. It was like the Crocodile Hunter doing porn, and after he died, my career was over. That was it.
I feel like his family owes you money. Because that was a career you had.
I feel like I owe his family money. It was going on, and then all of a sudden, like, the guy dies, and I'm into sausage.
I mean, outside of his own family, you were hurt the most by that death. Did you ever go seek revenge on the stingray that killed him? No, I think it's awful. I won't eat anything that
could eat you in the wild. The rules are, if it's, like, small, cute, and fuzzy, usually tastes really good.
Right. That's why I keep going down on my girlfriend. I think it's small, cute, and fuzzy as hell.
Adorable.
Now here's a fun game. Is he Asian or Mexican? Both?
Nah, I'm just kidding. Are you still hosting the podcast?
I actually just sold a new one to Feral Audio. Feral Audio has a lot of, like, My Favorite Murder is a huge podcast that's very famous. I've even heard of it, but you're busy. But anyway, my new one is called Mac and Cheese, because I realized that while I love music, I mostly love cheese music. So why not just talk about what I want to talk about?
Yeah.
I'm not a music snob. So I'm movies, TV, places, I bring guests on, comedians, and I say, what's the cheesiest thing that you genuinely love the most?
Yeah.
And then we talk about that. But look for Mac and Cheese. That's going to be my new podcast. I'm really excited about it.
That sounds super awesome.
But I'm doing one more Julian Loves Music as part of the New York Comedy Festival in November. And that'll be huge.
That seems so cool. You were going to die tomorrow.
Right.
Hopefully it's not the Jules bag that you're eating.
Right.
What would you choose to eat? Just like, fuck it, I'm going out.
Well, I love like a Chicago-style deep dish pizza. It's like a sausage.
That's not pizza.
Well, I know. Well, I love any kind of pizza, really. So any kind of the best kind of pizza, whatever.
Yeah.
I love pizza. I'm not fancy. Do you love uni, which is this, the urchin, sea urchin?
Yeah.
That's like my favorite flavor. It tastes like old books that you left in an attic. I love that. But really all I eat is like, I love hot dogs, I love cheeseburgers, I'm the worst. I'm like not fancy at all. The more you can make meat and cheese taste good, the more I'm like down for whatever.
I think that's like the only shit you and Donald Trump have in common.
Probably. Yeah.
Alright, so this is gonna be your dog. So this is the Jules Mac. That is a burger sausage.
So I can't believe you did this for me. I feel so honored.
So now we got
cheese. Oh, this looks amazing. I'm so mad that I can't eat the whole thing.
We're gonna do some secret sauce over there.
Okay. Wait, I wanna do one.
Oh shit, you should be doing
that. That's right, I'll do the next thing. I'm sure you have 19 topics for this thing.
Pickle. Just get a pickle wedge.
Okay.
Pickle wedge. Grammys for pickle wedge is awesome. So just
wedge it in there. Yeah, I put a pickle on a thing.
Onions?
So cabbage and then onions. I love raw onions on anything, really.
We're going to do a little bit of just sesame seeds on top.
Oh, those are sesame. If you had asked me, I wouldn't know how these work. So you can buy sesame seeds without them being on a bun?
You totally can.
Because I've been just buying a bunch of buns and then just taking the sesame seeds off. That's great. It's good to know. This looks amazing. All
right, so cabbage.
More cabbage.
So this is going to be like that traditional po' boy.
So this is the po' boy and doing...
what we do have though, the jalapeno remoulade that's gonna go on here, that's spicy.
Okay. Remoulade sounds like the fanciest word I've ever said. So not a remoulade, but like a remoulade. Huh? Let's cut that.
Now you're gonna put
pork shrimp.
Sweet that bitch down.
Oh, okay.
All right.
the best thing I've ever put in my mouth. And I'm not getting paid for this, so I don't have to say that.
He is not getting paid for this.
I am not getting paid for this. That was beautiful. I don't know how to describe it. I mean, the andouille is great. It's not too spicy.
Yeah, the andouille is not going to be that spicy.
What I like about it is you can taste every part of it. There's a lot going on, but you can still taste the shrimp. You can taste the remoulade. That's awesome.
So this is going to be your cheeseburger dog.
Okay. I'll be so embarrassed if the Jules Mag isn't good, but I think it's going to be great. I mean, how can this be wrong? Are we ready to go?
Yeah.
What? Jimmy, how are you not a billionaire?
I'm shocked.
This shit's amazing. I didn't mean to assume you're not a billionaire.
I'm not.
But we don't even have mics on, so I assume you're not a billionaire. Oh my god, that's so good. That's the best cheeseburger I ever had.
Then it's a sausage.
Yeah, I know. It's like, that's literally my favorite cheeseburger I've had. I can't remember. All I do is eat cheeseburgers. It's better than Shake Shack, I'll tell you that. Right.
Oh man, Danny Meyer. He didn't say that, but he did.
Shots fired. How do you do it?
Dude, I practice, man. I really like making sausages.
Man, oh man. I'm a fucking genius. I'm so excited. I want to say genuinely, it's very hard for me to be genuine because I am from Philadelphia. We're very sarcastic. But I'm touched that you made a fucking cheeseburger sausage for me. Now, if only I could be successful in my career, I'd really be happy. But then I'll do, this is, it's good. I'm famous enough to get this.
You
I'm
are
famous
too.
Enough.
You should see Julian. He's hilarious.
I'm very good.
He's my favorite comic to
watch. I'm very good. I'm
underrated. Your crowd work is my favorite of all.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's why I'm going on Saturday to the show.
All right.
And
well, thanks
thank
so much.
Thank you so much.
Great.
Thank you.
Great.